I want to talk to you about the current state of NXT. As Vic mentioned at the outset, you've been a staple. You've been a driving force behind the success of the Black and Gold brand for quite some time now. But more recently, we are getting to see a whole different Adam Cole. You are synonymous with the Undisputed Era. Obviously, so many memories, classic matches, war games. We can go on and on about the memories you guys created as a unit. Adam Cole has struck it out solo these days.
Yeah.
What does it feel like to you now, walking to the ring in NXT, a place you're incredibly familiar with, but you don't have that safety net, that security blanket of having the boys with you?
So it's actually kind of invigorating. And again, like when I look back on everything that me and the Undisputed Era did together, I do look back fondly on it. Like, again, to be able to come into it to a place like WWE where your anxiety and the pressure you put on yourself is at an all-time high, to be able to share that with people who I at one point considered brothers and people who I was very, very close with, traveled the road up and down with for 10 plus years. Like, again, I've known Kyle since 2009. I was in his wedding. Like, I mean, I've known him for a really, really long time. So to be able to share that with them was really cool. But truth be told, it was really exciting to be able to go, okay, I got to go do this on my own now. I got to make an impact and make an impression on my own. And so far, it's been really cool. It's been really exciting.
A week from Tuesday, you'll be going up against Kyle, Great American Bash, O'Reilly Cole 2. But, you know, before we started, Graves and the producers and I were talking about something that recently happened, and we're on the topic of Undisputed Era. Roderick Strong making his return with Diamond Mine. Just wanted to get your thoughts on Roderick Strong now branching out.
Yeah, Roddy is probably the toughest opponent I've ever been in the ring with. As far as like when you're done wrestling Roddy, you definitely feel like you wrestled.
I was going to say, Roddy's still wrestling you?
right. So he brings it. He always has, and he always will. So the idea of him being at the forefront, or what it looks like, of this new group is scary. I think it's scary for the entire brand. It's definitely scary for Kushida. It looks like he's made his name present there in that sense. So I think it's really cool in some senses to kind of see Roddy find this new crew and this new group. He looks as confident as ever. But I really hope Roddy stays out of my way, because the idea of having to deal with him this tense and this fired up is something I'm not ready to deal with right now. I'm going to be honest. Roddy's on fire. I could tell.
I want to ask you about your Tuesday night on NXT. You went one-on-one with Carmelo Hayes, a guy who's been getting some TV time. Looking across the NXT landscape, we're beginning to see a few unfamiliar faces, new guys waiting for their chance, waiting for their opportunity to step up. Carmelo brought it a couple weeks in a row, took Kushida to the limit, took you to the limit. Who else impresses you right now on the NXT roster?
So I've mentioned this name before, but it's really cool to kind of see them form, which is funny enough. We just talked about this new group that, you know, with Roddy. But Isaiah Swerve Scott is somebody I've always had my eyes on. And with this new group and this new crew that he has, I feel like he's really, really hitting his stride. To me, there's always been something about him that just stuck with me. It could be that, which I don't know if a lot of people know this, but I'm originally from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And I met
Amish country.
Amish country. And I met Isaiah Scott in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And I directed him towards the training academy that I was going to. And I kind of watched him grow as a talent through the independents all across the world. So to see him land in NXT has been really cool. And again, I knew kind of from the beginning that he was going to be really, really good. And now, again, to see him in the position that he's in has been really, really cool. So he's a guy I am 1,000% keeping my eye on. Like, I think a year from now, you're really, really going to see what he's capable of.
I will happily double stamp that statement. I've been very impressed by everything Swerve's doing. Yep. Hit row, everything. Really, really cool look, really cool vibe. I'm having a blast watching it right now. Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.